just a little boy, I like to roam the hills, and to hear wild stories about the Indians was my biggest thrill. I'd shout and run and holler like them, I wore moccasins on my feet, and I'd make believe I was under a teepee every time I went to sleep. Son, don't go near the Indians, please stay away. Son, don't go near the Indians, please do what I say. My hair was jet black and I was 21, there was lots of pretty girls around. Pale-faced maidens didn't thrill me none around my Cochise County hometown. One day when I was walking by a shady creek, I saw a beautiful Indian fetching water and I just had to speak. She smiled at me, then quickly ran, but the next day she returned. And it wasn't very long till I told this maiden how the love in my heart burned. Son, don't go near the Indians, please stay away. Son, don't go near the Indians, please do what I say. I told my daddy I'd found a girl who meant the world to me, and tomorrow morning I'd ask the chief for the hand of Noble Lee. Dad's trembling lips spoke softly as he told me of my life. Then he said I could never take this maiden for my wife. Son, when you were born, the white man and Indian were fighting, and a brave named Yellow Sun scalped my little boy. So I took you to make up for what he'd done. And son, you're a full-blooded Indian, but I love you just as much is my own little feller that's dead. Son, Noble Lee is your sister. And that's why I've always said, son, don't go near the Indians, please.